John, lay it out for us. What's been happening?
Okay, Angela. Well, as you said, Ventra is a brand new system, almost $500 million. CTA decided they didn't have the expertise to pull this off in-house, so they went through the privatization route, hiring Cubic Transportation of California to manage and run this new system. And it started late. It was supposed to start, you know, sometime early summer. It finally kicked off in late August for students, and there have been glitches all the way along the way in distributing passes, as well as how the system functions as well.
So enumerate these glitches. Some people are getting their passes late, some people are not getting them at all. What are the problems?
Yeah, there was supposed to be a seamless transfer, especially for Chicago Card and Chicago Card Plus customers. They were one of the first groups to receive this card, and they were automatically supposed to get their Ventra card. It started with some emails that were sent out by Ventra in August, but in many cases, individuals either did not receive those emails or they just lost those emails in the flood of email traffic that we all get every day. The Ventra card itself came in the mail many weeks later. So there's this disconnect there between the email, if you even got it, and the delivery of the Ventra card. What was so key about that email is that it had your temporary username and your temporary password that you would then need to go online at VentraChicago.com to activate your card. So therein lies a large part of the problem. We have thousands and thousands of people who finally got their cards. I mean, I know you haven't even received yours yet, but for those who did, many of them didn't receive the email, so they had really no way of activating that card short of calling Ventra and waiting what seems to be endlessly online to talk to a customer service representative.